Shoeburyness in Essex. Unknown to most people, this former garrison town was once at the centre of weaponry development, having been in use since the Iron Age. Today a public park, only the buildings give an indication of its past. The land at Shoebury Garrison was first purchased in 1849. Due to the vast size and distance from towns, ammunition could be shipped to the site, where it could then be tested and developed. Woolwich Common was primarily used, although as the weapons became more powerful, a new location was needed. Dating back to the 1850s, these powder magazines were some of the first buildings to be constructed. They're still standing in a good condition today, next to what appears to be the remains of a blast wall. But it's only up close that you can see the remains of a railway track, which would have been used for transporting goods in and out of the site. Towards the turn of the 20th century, defensive structures were upgraded, including the light quick firing battery and also the heavy quick firing battery. Shoeburyness's role in arms development continued, with breakthroughs in shrapnel, rockets, quick firing weapons, and the replacement of gunpowder with cordite, to name a few. Both of the World Wars saw new defences built, ranging from searchlight emplacements along the coast to air raid shelters. But one of the most significant developments was a wooden boom built in the Second World War. In 1950, it was upgraded with reinforced concrete to stop any Russian submarines getting to London. Over a mile of it still survives today. Today, the former garrison buildings have been converted into homes, although the military site next to it is still used for testing weapons and bomb disposal. Maybe in another 50 years, we'll learn about the weapons that are being tested there today.